Within the last 30 years, just off the east coast of the United States, more than 1,000 men, women, and children have vanished from the face of the earth. No one knows how or why. This is one explanation.
Clear for takeoff. One, 3, 6. You are clear for takeoff.
What is your problem, 1-3-6?
All right, buckle in, buckle in. Miami Rescue, this is 1-3-6. We are now ready for takeoff. Redhead? Blonde? Brunette?
Never got a chance to find out. What and where?
Mayday. Grid 725.
You won't believe this. The Devil's Triangle. Dead center.
Both units are airborne, sir, and proceeding to Mayday.
I do. I love you.
Pagolini. Pagolini, drop it down.
What for? We're more than 100 miles from target.
Just drop it down.
About 24 hours a day, day in and day out?
No, no. Sometimes I think about you, Pagolini, and your foul temper and...
Hey, watch it.
Yes, sir.
Wasn't too shabby, though. Not bad. Not bad at all.
I love you. Truly. Truly I do.
Thank you.
ahead, 137.
The bottom just dropped out of our thermometer here, and our intakes are icing up. We've got to return to base immediately.
Miami to 137. You're clear to return to base. How about 136?
I don't know what those guys are talking about. The weather's beautiful up here. Everything is clear to Mayday. Isaac Light, below.
Any sign of those two keepers? I'm serious. Explain how the keepers vanished off that island. Can you explain any of those spooky things that happened in the triangle? Explain them to me.
Huh? You know, we'd be famous. Haig and Paganini. I mean, Paganini and Haig. We'd be in the newspapers, talk shows, the whole enchilada.
Well, I told you what I think.
Yeah. Trouble is, not many people believe in the devil these days.
When you believe in God, you believe in the devil.
I believe in God. God, Santa Claus, Easter Bunny. A devil? That I can't quite swallow. Paganini and Haig. Like that.
I love you truly, Paganini.
Oh. 136 to base. Did 137 return safely?
Yes, 136. We've given full mechanical checkout and found no evidence of freeze-up. Need any assistance, 136?
No. Approaching target area now.
Roger. The Venturers will be there 0800 tomorrow morning.
Roger and out.
There's the flare. And there she is.
She's a motor sailor, big one. 80, 85 foot, easy.
You see anyone?
Not yet.
She looks abandoned. Is that a body hanging from the main mast? My God, it is.
There's another one on the forward hatch. I can't tell if he's alive. Looks like something moving inside. Give me the horn. Take the stick.
Got it.
Alarm, White. Please respond. This is the Coast Guard, Rick White. Please respond. Hello, Rick White. Please respond. This is the Coast Guard!
Better notify Miami. Miami Rescue, this is 136. Come in, please. Miami Rescue, this is 136. Come in, please. We've lost contact.
I better go down.
Okay. Hey. Watch yourself.
Right, buddy. in the hatch is dead.
What about the one on the mast?
He's dead too. And he's a priest. Read me.
Yes. Do you see anybody inside?
No, nobody's in the salon. I'm going below. Looks like it's blowing pretty bad up there.
It is. So get going.
And you stay away from those masks.
Full of electricity. Whole area looks screwy.
Now my engine's acting up.
The crew's quarters and the forward cabins are all empty. All I have left is aft.
Well, hurry it up.
Magdalene.
Go ahead.
Make sure the tape recorder is working.
It's been working. What do you got?
I found another one. A man.
And he's floating in the air.
What's the matter with you? Cut the jokes!
I'm not joking, Magdalene. He's floating in the air, and he's dead.
Dropping. Hank? Come in, Hank. Hank, come in.
take up a survivor.
Pagolini, can you read me now?
Pagolini, can you read me now? Over.
Both of you okay?
Is anybody hurt? Hey!
No, no, no. We're all right.
I don't know what happened to that cable.
But it looks like we're stuck here.
I'm afraid you are. I gotta get out of here fast. My engine started acting up again. My fuel to get back is borderline.
You gonna be okay?
Yeah. You promise to light me some candles when you get back to the base.
Hey! Hey!
Agnolini? Agnolini, can...
We're going to die on this boat, you know. Just like the others.
I'm not ready to die yet. She's solid, she's sound. She'll ride it out. And so will we. So why don't you make us some coffee while I try to find some dry clothes.
You'll find some in here. Underneath the mirror.
You want to tell me what happened?
Doesn't matter. I told you we're going to die soon. There's no way off this damn boat. All hope abandon, ye who board the requite.
Here, sit down. Sit. We're going to be all right. Sea's calm. Pretty soon the star is going to be coming out.
Don't you know where we are? Haven't you seen what's happened on this boat?
You see, they'll want to know what's happened. They'll want to know what's happened to the man on the deck, the priest, and the man in the aft compartment. So, so why don't you tell me?
All right. I'll tell you. We came here for a fish. Not just any fish. Hal's fish had to be a striped marlin and had to weigh at least 180 pounds.
Come on! Come on, Harry! I got him, Captain! I got him!
Sit up on the drag, Hal.
Man, look at him! Look at him! He's a beauty! Come on!
I'll take it.
Come on, baby! All right! Come on now! Come on in! Come on! Slow down, Cleo. Slow down.
Better slow down. It's going to sound.
How big you think he is? Think he's heavy enough?
He's plenty big.
Maybe I'm going to wear you out if it's the last thing I do. Come on now.
The weight was the most important thing. That and it had to be caught from a power sailor. Not a regular fishing boat. It had to be a power sailor. That's the way Hal's stepbrother did it. So that's the way Hal had to do it. Killed a panther in Africa. So Hal had to kill an even bigger one. It was that way with everything.
Including the Marlin?
Including the Marlin. I've never seen Hal so happy. He and Strickland were like little boys.
Hey, okay. Start reeling in. Open her up a little, Salil. Now pull back in the rod and sink that hook in as deep as you can. That's it.
Mouth like cotton. You got any water?
1-0.
Guano, water! Keep pumping that rod now. You got him.
That's it.
You got your bonus too, huh, Jack?
We haven't landed him yet.
Oh, we will, we will.
He's coming up now.
Yeah.
Pick up the line.
Yeah. Yeah, he's coming, all right.
Coming up now, pick up the line.
That's enough. Get away, get away.
Get the slack out of the line. Get the slack out.
Just about.
That's it.
Okay,
don't let the fish play you now. You play it.
Juan, take the hook.
As he does it, pull it in.
Come, baby!
What is it, Taleo?
Ah, got him.
A man adrift.
Taleo, what do you see?
Mother of God.
Come on, this is where all the action is, man. Take a look.
Right rudder.
Slow it down. Slow it down.
Mr. Bancroft, there's a man adrift off the starboard bow. We're going to have to let your fish go.
The hell we do.
We got to pick him up.
Radio the Coast Guard. Let them pick him up.
Hell, we've got to pick him up.
Let it go. Let it go.
Strickland. We lose that fish, and you lose $5,000. Now you let that sink in.
A man is worth more than any fish.
The hell you do. Oh. Get out of here.
A man of God is worth all the fish in all the seas.
Strickland.
That's gonna cost you. And you better believe it.
Let's pick that man up.
Hal came so close. I couldn't help feeling sorry for him.
Hey, give me that.
Get out of my way.
He came aboard, a strange lightning started, and the weather had suddenly changed.
You okay, Father?
I almost lost hope.
Get him alone. Get him some dry clothes and show him where he can rest up.
His face was filled with despair, yet there was a kind of inner strength.
That's just what you need, baby. Priest.
What's wrong?
The crew.
What do you mean?
Where do you think you're going?
We can't stay, Capitan.
What do you mean you can't? You get back aboard.
No, we cannot stay.
We cannot stay, but the priest be on this place.
What does he mean?
I said get back aboard now.
No! No! We cannot stay, Capitan, because there's going to be a battle. There's going to be a big battle. See, all this is the devil's place. And the priest will be tested, and my man will die, so we cannot stay.
And you'll die if you don't get back in his boat.
Whatever you want, Capitan. We will not stay, because we're going to die anyway. You understand?
Get back in his boat!
You don't make an escape.
I'm telling you, get back in his boat!
Don't! They're terrified!
No. That's not the way. Do not blame them for their beliefs.
Days without food, and this is the best I can do. It's hard to believe. I hope you'll excuse me.
I've read that happens to people. I mean, when they go without eating for a while.
Yes, my child, I've read it in a book.
Well, I can tell you that's one book that I haven't read. Evie, why aren't you eating?
He was handsome. Too handsome. Would have been easy to forget he was a priest.
You contact the Coast Guard?
I can't raise him. There's too much weather between us and the coast.
That's the way it was before we crashed. There was a storm. We lost radio contact.
I haven't heard any storm reports within miles of here for the past week.
Why don't you, just tell us about it, Father?
The weather reports were all clear when we left Santo Tomas. The sea was like glass. I asked the pilot to call Miami, so the ambulance will be ready for little Miguel when we arrived. The child was dying, and the parish, poor as they are, raised the money for the operation that would save his life. Suddenly, we were surrounded by these strange clouds. The pilot lost control of the plane. We tried to get off in Mayday, but the radio was dead. And then we crashed. Little Miguel and the pilot were dead instantly. The Cortineses were badly hurt, but it managed to put them onto a piece of a wing. But with little Miguel gone, they just didn't care. They just let themselves be swept into the sea.
How long were we in the air before it happened, Father?
15, 20 minutes.
Well, and how in God's name did you get way out here?
Where are we?
Well, you're about 250 miles northeast of San Tomas.
Triangle.
What do you mean, the triangle?
The devil's triangle. Well, at least that's what people call it.
Why?
Strange things happen here.
Come on, Father, come on!
What kind of things?
while the crash. Things like what's happening right here now. Strange lightning. Storms approaching. Out of nowhere. The radio not working.
Strange lightning. Come on, Father, that's connected with the... what do you call that thing? The Northern Lights. That's it, the Northern Lights.
As far as the radio's not working, everybody knows that the Earth's magnetic field is completely out of whack out here.
Yeah. That's it.
Perhaps. Some people believe that the triangle is the devil's place. And when it is time for one to die, he tests us here, as he did the Lord in the wilderness. That's why the crew abandoned us.
Marlin off the stern. Let's go, Strickland. We got a fish to catch.
Savvy, I bet you it's bigger than the one we had to cut loose.
You might get that 5,000 yet.
Well, we still got a line out. Strap in and hook in. Sileo! Sileo, stop the engine! What's the matter?
I can't get it started.
Let me try it.
Tagging it!
Better move it with the sail.
Ha, ha, ha! Ah, what a baby!
Help! Here, Sileo, let me do it. Hold it steady.
Crackland!
Then that strange lightning started again. Maybe the crew was right. We were in the devil's place. It was insanity. Absolutely insane. Here we were, hundreds of miles from anywhere. In this dreadful place called the Devil's Triangle. No crew. No radio. The engine wasn't even working. The storm was getting worse by the minute, and all anybody could think about was a damned fish.
Got it!
Get away! It could get rougher!
Don't you worry about me, Strickland. You just take care of the boat. I'll take care of the fish.
I'm freezing. Tell me more about this place.
It's been called the Devil's Triangle by seamen for hundreds of years. The natives call it el lugar del diablo, the place of the devil. Many people have been lost here. People, ships, small boats, even planes. Vanished without a trace.
Yet you survived.
There have been survivors before. Some claim they had seen the devil himself.
You said that this is a place where the devil tests us.
Yes. You could say that the Cortinises and I were tested.
And you passed the test. But the Cortinises, their baby and the pilot, they didn't. Why?
It's not a test of living or dying. It is a test of faith.
In God or in the devil?
What the hell is shooting for? He's already tied up.
We would have lost him.
All right, let's get him aboard.
Right. Hold him tight now. Slippery. Okay.
Man,
let that hook off.
He's a freak on now.
That's it. Okay, now grab hold now.
Seems your friend has caught his marlin.
You all right? Are you okay? Let's go. I said, give me a hand.
And Strickland finally pulled the fish on deck. Strickland got his $5,000 bonus. And Hal had beaten his stepbrother once again.
We better get him below or we'll lose him.
Then let's do it now.
Go over there, compartment. Hey, Father! Give us a hand.
Of course! You'd better stay inside, my child.
What they went through was madness. Madness. Here, you drink it. You'll need it. It took them nearly an hour. With Father Martin's help, they finally managed to get it secured below the deck.
You stored it below the deck?
Yes, there's a refrigerated room right by the storage compartment. Anyway, by the time that they were through, the rain had stopped as suddenly as it had started, and the wind had reached hurricane proportions. When Strickland and Father Martin came back, Hal wasn't with them. Where's Hal?
He's down below trying to imagine how to look at his trophy room.
Hal was more likely imagining the expression on his stepbrother's face when he realized Hal had beaten him once again.
Be able to hold her. We've got to get the sails down.
Father, will you take the wheel and keep headed into the wind?
Yes.
All right, Saleo, cut the sail.
Don't worry. Everything will be all right.
the Martine kept telling me everything was going to be all right. And then it happened. And then we saw Strickland. I ran. I was scared, but I ran to see if I could help him. Then I saw Saleo. I tried to call for help, but there was a flash of light, and he was gone. It was a nightmare. Saleo vanished without a trace, and Strickland dead, wedged in that hatch.
Let's go inside. You can better stay out here. Let's go inside. Let's go inside. Let's go inside.
Get me out of here. Strickland. Help me, Strickland.
Came to, it was calm, just like it is now. But I knew we were still in the devil's place. I felt his presence all around me. If Father Martin tried to hide it, I'm sure he felt it too.
The storm is over. The May Day signal is working. The Coast Guard is probably on its way.
We're going to die, Father. I know it. I just know it.
Easy, easy. Everything will be all right.
You really believe that, Father?
Yes, Eva. Have faith. Trust the Lord.
But this isn't the Lord's place. This is the devil's place. And he's here with us right now. Can't you feel him?
I feel only God's presence. Please, Eva, hold on to your faith. He will not forsake you.
He gave up on me a long time ago, Father.
You're wrong, Eva. We're all his children.
What do you think that I was doing with Hal? I'm a prostitute, Father. That's all I've ever been.
So was Mary Magdalene. And the Lord loved her. And he loves you.
And do you love me too, Father? Show me that you love me.
I love you, Eva. As God loves you. Listen. I told you to have faith. They're here. They came for us.
I don't hear anything.
Yes. I told you they were coming.
Father.
there. You hear it?
No.
I must be sure they see us.
Where are you going? You can't go up there. Father, there's nothing. Father, come down here. You've got to. Father, there's no one there. There's nothing. Father, don't leave me. Don't leave me here alone, Father. That's all I remember until you found me.
That it was you who I saw moving around down here.
Almost wish you hadn't. Enough have died on this boat.
No one's gonna die. In a couple hours, we'll be on our way to Miami. Both of us.
After what you've seen here, you can't really believe that.
I know it. You figure because we're in a place called the Devil's Triangle. The Devil's responsible for everything that's happened, don't you?
How else can you explain all that's happened here?
Come on. Come up on the deck with me.
No.
Come on. I want to show you something. Come on. Come on. No mystery here. When Father Martin heard us coming, he grabbed the flare gun. He wanted to make sure we could see his signal, so he ran to climb the mast. Father Martin was excited. Probably never been up on top before. He lost his balance when the platform, weakened by the storm, gave way. The fall snapped his neck. Are you all right?
Yeah.
Sure? You want to hear about Strickland? Huh?
Sure.
All right. Now, where were you and Saleo and Strickland and Father Martin came up after storing the Marlin?
Saleo was here.
By the wheel? Here?
No, I was right here when they were coming up the stairs.
From what you told me, Strickland was more concerned about his money than getting his engine started. Not just the $5,000 Hal gave him, but probably every dollar he'd ever earned. But instead of going directly to the engine room, he stopped at the bottom of the ladder to count his money. Boat pitched. You and Father Martin were flying through the air. And as the bow crashed back into the water, Strickland was catapulted through the hatch. The impact was bone crushing. He was dead before you ever reached him. want you to go out on the deck again with me. Come on.
I can't go out there again.
Yes, you can. Well, come on. There's nothing out here you haven't already seen. Show me exactly where you were when Saleo disappeared.
I was here.
And where was he?
There, up there.
He'd probably been drinking all day. Saleo should have tied off the booms before he cut the lines. Climbed up on the cabin to secure the main boom, knocked him unconscious and threw him into the ocean. Lightning probably blinded you the instant it happened.
Oh, God. How do you explain this? What's happened to Hal?
I believe I can explain this, too. Once he got the Marlin stowed in there, Hal stayed to admire his trophy. When the storm got worse, he was helplessly thrown about the cabin. He tried to get out, but was continually thrown back. Fearing for his life, he tried to climb his way out. Storm had jammed the door. That's when you heard him screaming for help.
You know something? I don't think I believe in the devil anymore.
Good.
What are you thinking about?
Pagnolini. The guy I fly with.
What about him?
I was just wondering if he made it back to the base all right.
You're really good friends, huh?
Pagnolini? Yeah. Yeah, I guess we are. Never thought about it much, but
we are. He's a good guy. A little square, but he's a good guy.
I'd like to meet him.
I hope you do. Agnolini. Now, there's a guy who always believes. He's a good guy. Like I said, a little square. No vices.
Like you.
No, I got a couple.
How soon do you think they'll be coming to get us?
Probably not till dawn.
Secured.
Is he always that angry?
Always.
Make sure we have enough pictures of that guy. This report has to be extensive.
Myers, get on the wheel.
How you find him, God only knows.
Magdalene, this is,
Eva.
How do you do?
Magdalene?
Fasten a belt and get her a helmet and a vest.
I don't need them.
Sorry, regulations.
No!
Magdalene, If she can survive the last 24 hours, she doesn't need a helmet.
Well, you can sure pick them, old buddy.
Like I told you, no vices.
We'll see.
Peterson, give me that radio.
Yes, sir.
Venturous 3 to Venturous.
Go ahead, Venturous 3.
Have me patch in through the chopper 136.
Roger.
Hey, find out what was the cause of all that back there?
Just another unsolved mystery of the Devil's Triangle.
Damn it! I asked you a question.
Okay, okay, Pagnolini. There's a logical explanation to everything. And no sign of the devil.
136, come in, please.
136.
This is Captain Dunnock. Let me speak to Haig.
Haig?
Yeah?
Captain Dunnock wants to talk to you on the walkie-talkie.
I'll talk to him back here.
Take it up here.
All right, Pagnolini.
Yes, sir, this is Haig.
Your transcript shows you found a dead body, male, hanging from the mast, correct?
Affirmative. He was a priest, Father Martin. First name, Peter.
Peter Martin.
That's not what we found. We found a woman.
Long blonde hair, about 5'8", 125 pounds. 136, I'm waiting for an answer. Respond.
Battle, Haig. You're mine.
Ah! Oh, my God.
What's we say? Come in, Captain Dunnock. Captain Dunnock, can you hear me? Come in, please. Come in, please. Come in, please. Can you hear me?
You'll find that's no longer working, Pagnolini.
What do you want?
You, Pagnolini. Your soul.
It's time, then?
It was for the others. It doesn't have to be for you. You know who I am.
I know.
Then you know I can't spare you, Pagnolini.
I'm not afraid to die.
Everybody's afraid to die, Pagnolini. I am the only one who can save your life. All you have to do is ask me to. Ask me, Pagnolini. Ask me to save your life, Pagnolini.
No! No, I reject you!
If I cannot have your soul,
no!
I will have your body, Pagnolini! Your wife will love me. Your children will love me. She will
no,
have me.
They won't. No, they won't. They'll reject you. No. As I reject you in God's name. Then go to your God, Pagnolini. Go to your God. God.
God.
God.
Oh.
Anything that is. Money out there. The best is all going to move. Press the knee both there.